So question four. Question four, the structure question four, figure 1.1 is a speed time graph for an ice skater. Explain what is meant by deceleration or how we define the term deceleration. The term deceleration means decrease in speed when the speed of an object decreases. We use the term deceleration. Use the figure calculate a distance travel between 3 seconds and 6 seconds. So from 3 to 6 seconds, what we have to do, we have, because the speed time graph, the area under the graph give us the distance travel. So if we need from 3 to 6 seconds, so this is 3 and this one is 6, so we need the area under this part only. So we have to identify what shape it is making. You can divide this into two parts. It actually it's making a trapezium, but you can divide into two parts. You can consider one as a triangle and another one as a rectangle. This is one way. Or you can use a trapezium for which the sum of the parallel side, half sum of the parallel side into height will give us the distance travel. So it is half sum of the parallel sides into height will give us the distance travel. Now, what are the parallel sides? You can see the blue lines which I draw from 3 seconds, a vertical blue line. From 3 seconds to 6 seconds, these are the parallel lines. So this one is A and the other one is B. So this one is A. So it is starting from zero, because to read the vertical line is starting from zero and ending at 5. So what is the value of A? A is equals to 5. What about the second parallel line? It is starting from 0 and ending at 11. So 0 to 11, the value of B is equals to 11. And what is the distance between them? From 3 seconds to 6 seconds, the distance between them, that is equals to 3. So it will be half sum of the parallel side. So one of the side is 5, another side is 11, and multiplied by height, which is 3. So when we solve the sum of the parallel side, 5 plus 11, that is 16. And then 16 multiplied by 3, and that is divided by 2. Is it clear? So 5 multiplied by 6, 5 plus 11, that is 16, 16 multiplied by 3. So that is 48, and 48 divided by 2, so that's equal to 24 meters. So the distance travel is equal to 24 meter. Or you can also divide into triangle if you find trapezium a bit difficult. So what you can do, you can divide into a triangle and rectangle. So you'll find area of the triangle and area of rectangle. What will be the area of triangle? Half. What about base? It is starting from 3 and ending at 6. So base is 3. And what about height? It is starting from 5, because for triangle is starting from here, 5 and ending at 11. So height is 6. So when we solve 3 multiplied by 6, that's 18, and 18 divided by 2, 9 meter. The second one is a rectangle. So we'll take area of this rectangle. The length, it is starting from 3 and ending till 6. So it is 3. And the height, it is 5, so 3 multiplied by 5, which is 15. And now what is the total distance? So area of triangle plus area of rectangle. So 9 plus 15 will also get 24. Is it clear? This part? Then use figure 1.1 to determine the distance. Now question 5, figure 1.1 shows a rocket powered sledge traveling along a straight track. The sledge is used to test the component before they are sent into space. Figure 1.2 is a speed time graph for a sledge from time t is equals to 0 second. On the figure, mark a point P to indicate when the acceleration is not constant. Look, when it is a straight line speed time graph, the point where it is straight means the region where it is straight, it means it is a constant acceleration. And this point as well, you can see it is also a straight line. So this is also representing a constant acceleration. So only the region where it is constant, its acceleration is not constant, is this region. Yeah, it is constant. Even it is constant around 2.4 seconds. So we have to mark a point P anywhere you can mark in this region. Because they are asking on a figure, mark a point, label P, where acceleration is not constant. If I mark a point P here, this will be wrong. Why it will be wrong? Because here the acceleration is constant. But we have to mark where the acceleration is changing or it is a curve. That's why it is not on the 2. It should be after 2.3. Is it clear? The first part. Then calculate the acceleration at time is equals to 1 second. So when time is 1 second, what we do, we'll work out whether it is a straight line, because when we have a speed time graph, so if we have a speed time graph and we want to find acceleration, then we have to check whether the graph is a straight or it is a curve. If it is a straight line graph, then what we use to get the acceleration, we can directly use a formula. But it is a curve, then we'll draw a tangent and then we will find the gradient. So here we want the acceleration when time is equals to 1 second. So when time is equals to 1 second, what is this graph? It is a straight line. So if it is a straight line when time is equals to one, what we can use? We can use a formula in which acceleration is change in velocity divided by time. So what is the final what is the starting velocity? It is starting with zero. What is the final velocity? The third block, because between 0 and 200, there are five boxes. So each box is representing 40. So 40, 80, and this will be 120. So the final speed is 120. Initial speed is 0. And what about the time interval from 0 to 1 second? So that is 1. So it will be 120 meter per second square. So acceleration here is 120 meter per second square. Is it clear? This part. Then determine the distance traveled between 1 second and 2 seconds. So we want to calculate the distance between 1 second and 2 seconds. So in this region, so between 1 second and 2 seconds, again, you can see what it is making. It is making a trapezium. and for trapezium it is half sum of the parallel side into height. So what are the parallel side in this example? This is 120. This is the one first parallel side and this is the second parallel side. So 120, this is 200, and the distance between them it's 240, not 200, because it is one box above 200, so it is 240, and the distance between them is 1. So height is equals to 1. So 1 by 2, 120 plus 240 multiplied by distance between them or height, that is 1. So when we solve 120 plus 240, that's 360. 360 multiplied by 1 is 360 divided by 2. So when we solve, we'll get 180 meters. Is it clear, the last part, that how we worked out the distance traveled by this sledge from a time? So whenever there's a speed time graph, what you have to do, you have to use area under the graph to calculate the distance traveled. Then speed time graph, describe the motion. So for graph figure 1.1, it is a constant acceleration. And figure 1.2, the acceleration is decreasing, but you don't say deceleration. If you say deceleration, it will be wrong, because deceleration means the speed should also decrease. So acceleration is decreasing, but speed is not decreasing. That's why we don't say deceleration. Is it clear? That was the last question from topic 1.2, motion.